Hi, this is Roro from Roro Rants. And first of all, I want to say I'm a wise old woman. I've been through a lot. I started my career in the 80s. I've been through the Cold War with Reagan. I've been through 9/11. I've been through it all. And I'm here to tell you my opinion and what's happening with the news. I went to the DC March for Democracy rally, and it was awesome. I saw so many awesome speakers, and I can't even name them all. I don't want to leave anybody out, but you know, Arne Menconi was there, and he was wonderful, and Tim Canova, and oh God, I forget some of their names. I'm very forgetful. Tim Black was there. My favorite show, Tim Black. Love Tim Black. Anyway, but there was one thing that kind of struck me, that struck a nerve. Bruce Carter was there. I don't know if y'all remember him, but he founded the Black Men for Bernie. Big Bernie supporter. And, you know, he really helped us out with getting the black vote out for Bernie. Anyway, he is now supporting Trump. And he said it during the rally. He got a lot of boos. Tim Black went and interviewed him later. Because basically, I was listening to the speech and it was all bullshit. I didn't hear anything in his speech on policy-wise why he would be supporting Trump. I waited and waited and nothing happened. No policy speech. So it all sounded like a bunch of bullshit. Then some skinny little white boy came up and called him out. Had a megaphone, was calling him out, saying he's a fraud and this and that. And they let him speak, you know, because they said, this is an open forum, go ahead and speak. Kid said that he took $600,000 and kids in Texas and something about money for hungry children, whatever. So anyway, I looked it up and it's true. He wasn't convicted, so maybe he didn't really do it. It was probably just mismanagement. Maybe he did take the money. I don't know. But anyway, skinny little white boy was right. So anyway, then after he spoke, Tim Black went and tried to ask him again, what are the policies of Trump that make you want to support him? And he said something about partnerships and money and stuff. So it seems to me like, you know, the Republican Party, because why would you go from Bernie to Trump? That's like going from somebody who wants to help you to the fire. Now, I agree Hillary is corrupt, but going from Hillary to Trump, you know, which many uneducated, you know, people, ignorant people might be voting for Hillary and you want to get them to vote for Stein, not to Trump. That's like going from the frying pan into the fire. But anyway, he still had nothing to say that made any sense. And he said something about partnerships. And so I looked it up and yeah, of course, the Republicans are going to give money for a campaign. Once that campaign's over, that money's going to dry up. There ain't going to be nothing. So I looked that up and I found a lot of videos of, you know, black people for Trump, a lot of black people supporting Trump. And I was like, oh, fuck. Oh, my God. What is going on here? Have they lost their mind? You know, and like this Patriot citizen said, the Republican Party is full of KKK, alternate right nationalists, Aryans, skinheads, three percenters, oath keepers, neo-Confederates, and neo-Nazis. He said he's not a politician like Hillary, so he can call them deplorable. They make up a large percentage of the Republican Party and 0% of the Democratic Party. Like I said, when you vote for someone, you don't just look at the personalities. Maybe Hillary's corrupt, but the Democratic Party does want to do, has a lot of good people in it and does want to do a lot of good things to help us. So just, and he goes on, he says, so just like those who struggle for black freedom and justice chose the Democrat Party, those who fought against and continue to fight against black freedom and justice found their home in the Republican Party. And that is true. And no matter what Trump says, he's lying. He's one of them. He wouldn't even denounce the head of the KKK. Anyway, I'll go on. So I looked up, why are these people voting for Trump? Well, it's because Trump is promising jobs. He's saying that he's gonna get jobs. And of course, black people need jobs. We need jobs, that's true. We need jobs in this country. So I looked up the policies. I looked up the Trump site, the Clinton site, what Bernie had said he wanted to do, what Jill says she wants to do, and even Gary Johnson. I looked up all the candidates. because, you know, Bernie's not running anymore, but he did have everybody supporting him. Everybody wanted his plan. So now I'm comparing all the candidates with what Bernie wanted and look to see what their job plan is. And I'm going to put the pictures up so you could see. You know, Trump does not have a plan for job. His only plan is tax cuts for the rich. This is the same old trickle-down economics that never works for Republicans. Even if, and as far as trade, even if he could reverse any trade deals to bring factories back here, they're not going to be bringing those high-paid manufacturing jobs. So the manufacturing is dead in this country. It ain't coming back. If they did open up any factories, they would be using robots to do all the work. I worked in a job where they were selling stuff to automate factories back in the 90s. It was in between my going back to school to get a job teaching after the Cold War and then, you know, before I got my teaching job. So I worked there. No, it was after the teaching job before I got married and moved to Oklahoma. I'm not going to go into all that, but I worked there for about a year. They were automating jobs back then. The loss of jobs are not all because of trade. They're because of automation. Yeah, they can go over to other countries and get people to work for 6 cents an hour so they can have a bowl of rice every day or whatever, but they would also save money here if they got robots to do it. They're not gonna hire people for $20 an hour anymore and benefits and health care and retirement plans. It's not gonna happen anymore. It's dead. That's why Jill Stein wants to go towards the Green New Deal, survival mode. You know, we gotta go into survival mode. We gotta go into growing food, getting water, because this is what our country is getting to. And everybody gets a living wage, no matter whether they have a job or not. But now we got a lot of work to do, so everybody needs jobs. So anyway, I looked into this. So the only way the government creates, the government doesn't create jobs. This tax cut he's talking about is not gonna happen. They have tried this. All it does is increase the inequality gap between the rich and the poor. Giving tax cuts to the rich does not create jobs. They've tried it. I have this other picture which shows, and I'll show, if you look at all the presidents throughout history, all the Democratic presidents created jobs. Truman created jobs, Eisenhower less jobs, Kennedy more jobs, Johnson even more jobs, Nixon less jobs, Ford even less jobs. Then we got Carter, more jobs. Reagan, less jobs. George W. Bush, way less jobs. Then we had Clinton, more jobs than any president. Then you go down to George W. Bush, abysmal. The least number of jobs in history. And then because of his deregulation policies, the crash, which lost us all the fucking jobs. George W. Bush, that crash in 2008 caused the loss of all the fucking jobs. 5 million job loss. Then Obama has been trying to creep his way back and creep us back to, you know, and he's done a pretty good job of it. He's created about half the jobs that Clinton did, and that's not too bad. Considering he's had Republican opposition through the whole thing. The reason he couldn't do better is because the Republicans control the House and the Senate. What you gotta do is you gotta go out and vote in the midterms too. You can't just vote for president. You gotta go out and vote in the midterms and vote for Senate and get the Democrats in there too so they could support the Democrats, whatever. But next time we're gonna have the Green Party in there, so it's not gonna matter. Anyway, let me get back to the plans of each president, what they wanna do. So Trump's plan is abysmal. Tax cuts for the rich are not gonna work. The only way government creates jobs is through a stimulus package. And what we need now is a big stimulus package to fix our broken infrastructure that is crumbling, that is causing, we got people being poisoned from the water. I mean, it's just like the Roman Empire collapse. We're policing the whole globe, and then here at home, we're all dying and our infrastructure's collapsing. It gets a grade of D minus in the world. So here's the plan. Now, Bernie wanted to put a $1 trillion infrastructure package that would create 13 million jobs. That's great. And he wanted to have a $15 minimum wage federally. Now that would be awesome. Now Jill Stein wants a $13 trillion infrastructure package. Now don't ask me how we're going to pay for this. We're a sovereign nation. Taxes don't fund spending. Go listen to Steve Grumbine on Real Progressives if you want. It's all a lie about the deficit, the debt, and all that. Go listen to Steve Grumbine. So Jill Stein, $13 trillion for the Green New Deal that would create 20 million jobs, and also she wants to guarantee a job for everyone that needs one, and also the same $15 minimum wage like Bernie wanted. Okay, now Hillary, not as good. $275 billion infrastructure package that would create about 3.6 million jobs. Not as good, but something. Like I said, the Republicans will fuck you in the ass. The Democrats will at least give you a reach around. That's what you're gonna get in this world, okay? And Hillary, not a $15 minimum wage, but a $12 minimum wage. It's better than nothing, okay? Better than what we got now. What is it, $7 or $8 is nothing. Now listen to Trump. No stimulus package, none. Really? Rely on big business? Yeah, right. How is that working out for us now? It's not. He doesn't want to increase the minimum wage at all. In fact, he said Americans make too much money. Really? Seriously? Is that why people that are working two jobs are still on food stamps? Oh, but they won't be, because you know why? He wants to cut that program. Fuck him and his lies. He has no jobs. Wake up, people. Fuck, these fucking people are stupid. Anyway, those are the plans, okay? Trump is definitely the worst. Oh, I forgot to do Gary Johnson. He also wants to leave it up to business. Some of the things he's better with, like he wants to, you know, decriminalize marijuana. That would be good for the country. There are some things that are better, but he's not much better. So as far as I'm concerned, Trump is the worst. Gary Johnson is the next worst. Then Hillary, then Bernie. Jill Stein is the best. The best plan. So now, if you're ignorant and you don't know anything and you're voting for somebody that's not good for you, you know, that's your business. It's not your fault. You're just uninformed. But these people that have platforms that go on YouTube and say that they're progressive and try to get other people to vote for Trump, that's where I have a fucking problem, okay? If you have millions of followers and you've made a black man for Bernie thing and then you turn around and now you're trying to tell people to vote for Trump, that's the wolf in sheep's clothing, people. That's a sellout. That's a sellout that took money from Republicans and will say anything for money. Okay, I'm not that sellout. I'm not doing this for money. You don't see any advertisers on my channel. I'm doing this. I'm retired. I'm just doing this because I care about the country. Because I've lived through a lot, and I've seen a lot, and I've seen our country just go downhill. It is like the movie Idiocracy, you know? It's just getting worse and worse. So anyway, that's my video for today. I hope it's not too long. Watch some other videos from Roro Rants. Peace out.